everyone, welcome back to Anonymous World. Hope you all are doing well. So today is December 16th and day 16 of Advent of Cyber 3rd edition is out. So let's see what we have in day 16. Okay, so day 16 is OSINT Ransomware Madness. OSINT is my favorite area. Okay, so let's see the story. So Grinch Enterprises had decided to use the Best Festival company to try their new ransomware service. Okay. While they think that this is a great proving ground, Skiddy is adamant to determine their goals and share them with the wider security community. So, can we use our open source intelligence methods to find out more information about their ransomware gang? So, now Grinch Enterprises are running a ransomware service. So, objectives of today's task: understanding what is OSINT and where it originates, implications of OSINT and how it can be used for reconnaissance and information gathering, and how we can conduct an OSINT investigation to gather information on an individual. Okay, so a description of OSINT is given below. So OSINT stands for Open Source Intelligence, information that can be obtained from free and public sources. Okay, so offensive teams use OSINT to perform reconnaissance on a target, an individual, or an organization or corporation. So it may seem scary at first. Where do I find this information? Will I get in trouble? No need to worry. Most OSINT operations are straightforward using tools you are already familiar. Okay, so it is an extensive term and overreaching term of many different intelligent disciples. Okay, then in this task, we will be focusing on how we can leverage the ClearNet to our advantage to gather information on a specific target. Then there is OSINT process cycle. So when you conduct an OSINT investigation, each individual and team will have their methodology to approach the task. It can be quantified through models and systematic steps to follow. Okay, so two arrays OSINT information models are given below from this research paper. You can go through this research paper if you wish. Okay. Then there is account discovery and analysis. So accounts are a prevalent and well-known part of target's footprint. It can include any public account linked to target or a target persona. Okay, then we have Google Docking. So Google is definitely our best friend. Unfortunately, a simple Google search will not give you your desired result. So Google has known feature called Google Docs that will allow you to use a specific syntax in a search query to filter further and make your search more granular. Okay, so Google offers a defined list of key terms. So few key terms are given here which you can use for your Google searches. This is a small list of possible key terms. So like first is site. So purpose of this term is to specifically searches that particular site and list all the result of that site. Then you have file type. You can search for any particular file type like PDF, PPT. Then you have link, then in URL, then before, after. There are many more. So you can do your research on Google Docs. Then OSINT and the blockchain. So with the introduction of Web 3.0, or decentralized web protocols, setnets and fancy, and the increased popularity in cryptocurrencies, OSINT from a blockchain technology has become increasingly important. So it is completely open while remaining anonymous. This comes with its pros and cons from an OSINT perspective. So let's go ahead. Then we have going deeper. At its core, OSINT is searching and identifying information. So, however, we also need to look at how we can use platform functionality to our advantage to get further information. So, each platform have its own unique functionality and tricks. For example, GitHub. In GitHub, we can see previous updates by going on that commit option. Okay, then compiling an investigation. The most daunting part of an OSINT investigation can be starting and putting all of pieces together. So there is no need to worry. You will almost always be given a starting point or some from reference which to begin. So let's see our tasks. So we are the responding intelligence officer on the hunt for more information about the infamous Grinch Enterprises new ransomware gang. So as a response to the recent ransomware activity from Grinch Enterprises, our team has managed to collect a sample ransomware note. Okay, so it's a sample ransomware note. What language is this? Okay, we can see a Grinch 231, then some IDs. Okay, let's try using Google Translate. Okay. Okay, so it's Russian. Important, your files were encrypted by the Grinch. We use the most advanced encryption technology. Contact your Grinch Enterprises operator to access your files. Your personal ID is this. The operator assigned to your case can be contacted as Grinch231 on all platforms. Okay, so it was in Russian, and we can see we have one username, Grinch231, and a personal ID. So quickly, let's note it down. Okay, let's see. We have a personal ID. Okay. Then we have a username. Grinch231. Okay, so let's go ahead. What to answer here? Let me refresh this. Okay, so it was no answer needed. What a drag. So what is the operator's username? So we just found the operator's username, which is Grinch231. Okay, now what social media platform is the username associated with? Okay, so let's hunt for this particular username. So at first you can simply try searching the username just by typing this, Grinch231. Okay, so don't think there are any username here. Amazon, eBay. Okay, so all these shopping sites are coming. Let's see images. Okay, so we have some images. Okay, they all are back while covers or either shopping sites. Okay, so now we can use our Google docking. So after this username, just enter your key term site, then in which site you want to search. So let's see if you want to search in on Twitter. Okay, let's see. Okay, still we didn't caught anything. I don't see anything related to Grinch. Okay, let's try some other site. Let's try LinkedIn. Okay, did not match any documents. Let's try it. Okay, let's search for Grinch 31. Grinch 31. Okay, Mary Grinch was replying to. Okay, we can see a username here. Okay, send me all your ransom. Okay, we have a profile picture. This profile looks promising. So let's see tweets and replies. Verifying myself, I am Grinch231 on keybase.io. Then some addresses given here. Snowflakes are my favorite. Obsidian is better. Okay, so quickly let's take note of this. So we have an address. Let's copy this. Okay. Let's see. Verifying myself. Okay, so many people have commented here. Okay, let's go to this website. Okay, so this is a keybase.io account, and this is the profile of Grinch. We can see same profile picture at both the places. Okay, so now we are at one device is here. Okay, the device is Windows device. Okay. Then we have Twitter account, then we have one GitHub account, and then we have one Bitcoin address. So let's see the question. Which social media platform is the username associated with? So that's Twitter. What is the cryptographic identifier associated with the operator? So let's see if this one is correct. Okay, cool. Now, what platform is the cryptographic identifier associated with? Okay, so let's check this address. Okay, so it's keybase.io. Created fresh keybase account, adding first key, added encryption key, added Bitcoin address, claimed on ownership. Claimed ownership of GitHub account. Okay, so let's try keybase.io. Okay, what is the Bitcoin address of the operator? So we just discovered the Bitcoin address. Now let's copy it from here. Okay, so what platform does the operator leak the Bitcoin address on? Okay, so now we are left with one GitHub account. Let's navigate there. Okay, so our username is ChristmasHater31, but the profile picture is same. Let's see, there are two repositories, Christmas Stealer and ChrisBastry. So let's see the first one, Christmas Stealer. Okay, so one CPP file is here. Let's see. It's ransom.cpp. Okay, so we can see one address, our Bitcoin address is here. Is this the code for ransomware? Make sure we always allocate at least one indirect block pointer. Okay, I don't think that's make any sense here. Okay, let's go back. Okay, so you can see one commit is here. So we just read in description that some website has their own functionality and tricks to do an investigation. Each platform will have its unique functionality and tricks that can be used for our OSINT investigation. So let's see if we find something in history. Okay, let's see. Okay, so it's all green with, so nothing was changed. It was the original initial upload. Okay, what we can do is check the another repository, which is ChrisBastry. Let's see. Okay, there are three files. Let's see what's first one is Docker file. Okay, from Alpine, let us copy. Okay, nothing's there. Then we have license. Okay, this is just a normal license. Then we have a tree.sh. I think it's a file to print the Christmas tree on the screen during when they ask ransom. Okay, nothing's there. Okay, there are four commits. Let's see each commit one by one. Okay, so the first one is initial commit. Nothing's there. Then create a Docker file. Okay. Create tree.sh. That's also fully green. No, nothing to see. Then there is update tree.sh. Okay, here's the red one. You can see two line echo created by Dante Heath and echo contact DanteHeath21@gmail.com. But you can't see this file in there. Let's go back. Okay, so you can't see those lines here. Means that was deleted by the author later. So that's how you find information from unique functionality of each platform. So let's go and answer our questions. So what platform does the operator leak the Bitcoin address on? So it was GitHub. We saw the Bitcoin address in ransom.cpp file. Now what is the operator's personal email? So we just found the operator's email. Let's copy that. So it's dantehath@gmail.com. Now what is the operator's real name? So it was dantehath. Sorry if I am pronouncing it wrong. Okay, so we are done with our ransomware madness. So OSINT is really, really fun. You should do more research on OSINT and try different OSINT challenges available online and learn more ways to find information from the internet. So that's all for this video. I will see you tomorrow in day 17.